On this Thanksgiving, a remarkable story of generosity that started more than 1,000 miles away.
ABC 7 News anchor Dion Lim joins us now with a story that's creating a movement to help those affected by the campfire. Dion.
That's right, Cheryl and Amma. This is a Thanksgiving story like no other, where the turkey is traded for gas station food and nearly 20 hours of driving, all to deliver a very special gift, one that is inspiring others to do the same.
Luna and I are going to be together the whole week, and I was like, what are we going to do?
For James Faircloth and his six-year-old daughter, Luna, a traditional Thanksgiving just would not do.
You know, the option was to stay in Denver, stuff ourselves with food, take naps, watch football, and that's just, we couldn't do that.
Not when 1,000 miles away in the Bay Area, a place where this Denver man used to call home more than a decade ago, the community was suffering.
We were just really moved by what was going on.
84 dead, 500 still missing, 14,000 homes destroyed by the raging campfire in Butte County. That's when the mission began.
I went to the Chico Craigslist site and just saw this outpouring of need from people and was just decided we had to do something.
That's something raising money to buy an RV to house a family in need. In just a few days, James surpassed his fundraising goal, purchasing a pre-owned six-passenger Class A motorhome, and was on his way 19 hours to Chico.
Here we are, just outside of Vegas, headed your way.
Then along his journey, a remarkable chance encounter with this woman, Patricia Bittrick of San Francisco, who has an RV she's wanted to donate for some time.
I went onto the Chico Craigslist site. I feel in awe of him.
They've now partnered up, fielding hundreds of requests from the burn zone community, trying to find families who need the RVs.
If we had 100, we wouldn't have enough.
But maybe, just maybe, as this father-daughter road trip to remember continues, they'll start a movement for more people to donate. The Faircloths have so much to be grateful for this Thanksgiving.
It's the best one we've ever had, I would say. I've had 50 of them. It's been amazing.
That movement has already begun. We learned late tonight a woman in Reno, Nevada, of all places, heard about this story and also plans to donate an RV, making it three. James says he'll choose a recipient in the next day or so. And if you have a motorhome you'd like to donate or send a message to James with a suggestion of who needs help, you can visit our website, abc7news.com.